April is Financial Literacy Month, and don't we all want our kids to be smart about money? But it can seem tough to teach them about how to save, manage their money, even invest their money.
Well, they're pretty smart about learning how to spend it.
Yeah, that doesn't take any skill. All right, Julie Kiras is here with some ideas that will make learning fun for the whole family. And I read a statistic when we had someone on that's an investment advisor that most kids have their it's locked, their ideas about money by under the age of 10. I mean, they have their ideas. So it really matters what you do when you're young.
It does, and kids are learning their money habits from their parents at home. And so that's the place to really teach them some smart and better money habits. And just to get them on a path to success. So one of the things I like to do with my kids, we have this big money magnetic coins and bills, is just put it on the fridge and help them learn money counting skills, making change. I still think it's relevant today, even though everything's digital. But I think it's important for them to understand equivalent values and things like that. So the big money is fun for them, and you could just do one little thing a day on the fridge, and that's really fun for them.
Yeah.
But also, you know, Ben Franklin said to, when you involve me, I learn. And so a great way to learn about money is through playing games. There's all sorts of games on the market to learn about money, but this is a new one that just came out last year. It's called Franklin's Fortune, and it's a really high-level game. It's more for your teens, and it teaches concepts about money, like the relationship between work and earning money, values like persistence and integrity, real-life application of money skills and managing money. You start out, it's a really cool game made by a dad in Massachusetts who was teaching money skills to his kids. He designed it and everything. You start out as a tradesman, and through work and energy, you earn money and you can move up and level up in your success.
Ah,
and it brings in the idea of like education and experience influences how successful you can be. So I really loved this game. I played it with my husband last weekend. We had a good time. Yeah.
No kids, just you and your husband.
Right. We don't have teenagers yet, but I'm excited for when they're teens to play this game. And you have like money and all these cards that you play in the common, and then you play with your sunrise deck. So it's all based on Benjamin Franklin's wisdoms and stuff.
And a lot more than Monopoly, obviously.
Right. You know, and it's not about just get all the money you can. It's really about how your relationship with your time and energy investment helps you succeed.
In terms of practical things out there in life, I know last summer our son wanted a tennis racket, and so we said, well, you need to earn it. So he wanted a lemonade stand. And we put up the money at the front, and he made it back quickly. And
that's teaching them about investment skills and managing. And so then you have some curriculum tools for parents that are really cool. Like Money Savvy has this Money Savvy piggy bank, and they come in different styles. And they actually have four compartments. So kids learn saving, spending, giving, which is so important, and investing.
I love that it's visual, because we'll say this to your kids. Oh, you're supposed to save 10%, donate 10%. But they don't know what that is.
Right.
So to see that, most piggy banks are just, put it all in there.
This is great.
Yeah, and actually you can take the different compartments out and take just that compartment out when you're ready to spend it. I guess, I don't know. It'd be harder to come out.
Yeah, that's true.
And then for teens, the Money Savvy has a Cash Cache, which is a personal money organizer, teaching them with these pouches to organize their money. So it's a little bit more sophisticated for teenagers who might not want to use a piggy bank, but it's just teaching them how to organize money, set goals, like you were saying, setting goals with your lemonade stand, and what are you going to invest and things like that.
Well, he had to buy a second tennis racket because we had already bought him one, but he wanted a special one.
Yeah.
So, well, then that one you have to earn.
Yeah. Right, that's
a good concept. So here's chores.
A lot of people have heard of Dave Ramsey and his Financial Peace. Well, this is Financial Peace Junior for kids, and it's a curriculum for parents to teach kids how to be money smart.
Okay.
And it included, you have a chore chart, you have goal setting, you have the envelope system that Dave Ramsey talks about, you have a parent guide, an activity book, and the there's also the set of storybooks. You can even start kids as young as 3 and 4 learning about money concepts like work and chores and debt and saving and spending and making goals with your money, and just teaching kids there's more that you can do with money than just spending it.
You can
invest it, you can give it, you can help others with your money.
Julie, if you don't teach your kids about money now, what happens later in life to them?
I think they're just on a path to going into debt, making poor choices, and really what we want for kids is to be independent with their money.
Yeah.
And to learn
and not
to
be so impulsive. Yeah.
Yes, and to learn how to take that as a resource to improve their life and to then give and improve the lives of others.
And it can be fun. So for more information on all the products that you see here, you can always visit Julie's blog. It's happystronghome.com. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thanks, Julie.